हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ योर चैप्टर अ गिफ्ट ऑफ चप्पल्स. सो वी हैव सीन हाउ द म्यूजिक मास्टर वॉज प्लेइंग द वायलिन एंड कंपैरेटिवली हाउ लाली वॉज डीरेलिंग द ट्रैक्स. ओके, सो सडनली देयर केम अ वेल. वेल मीन्स अ क्राई एट द गेट. वॉट वॉज द क्राई? अम्मा ओ. So someone was calling Amma. Okay, Ravi, send that beggar away. So who was there at the gate? It was the beggar who was calling Amma for food or something. Okay, now Ravi, send that beggar away, cried his mother from the back veranda where she was chatting with Tapi. So where Tapi and Rukumani was, they both of them were talking or chatting. She said from there, Ravi, send that beggar away. आप उस beggar को वापस भेज दो. Okay. He has been coming here every day for the past week and it's time he found another house to beg from. She said that now it's the time for the beggar कि वो अब दूसरा house ढूंढ ले. Okay. Now, Pati explained to Tapi. Mridu and Meena followed Ravi out. The beggar was already in the garden making himself quiet at home. So now Ravi just went towards the beggar and Meena and Mridu just followed him. So he was already there in the garden, making himself comfortable there in the garden. So he had spread his upper cloth under the neem tree. Unhone neem tree ke side mein apna upper cloth rakh diya tha and he was leaning against its trunk. Trunk means that branch of the tree. So he was just leaning, bent, was relaxing there. Apparently prepared to take a little snooze. Snooze means a little short sleep. Okay, while he waited for the arms to appear. Now, arms here means what? Whatever would come, right? Whatever would come, a money or food from grandmother. That means not from grandmother, but from Rukumani aunt. Okay, so jo bhi aane wala tha, he was waiting for the arms. Arms means jo bhi unko food ya jo bhi kuch milne wala tha. So he was just waiting and he decided that he would just take a short sleep till the time the arms would come. Go away, Ravi said sternly. Sternly means seriously, he just said, go away. My Pati says it's time you found another house to beg from. He said that my Pati is saying that you should now go to some other place to beg. Okay, so he just sent him away. The beggar opened his eyes very wide and gazed at each other. So the beggar opened his eye and he was just gazing, staring at each of the children. The ladies of this house, he said at last in a voice choked with a feeling, are very kind souls. I have kept my body and soul together on their generosity for a whole week. I cannot believe that they would turn me away. So he was like that these ladies of this house are very kind. And I don't think, मुझे नहीं लगता कि वो मुझे ऐसे turn away कर देंगी. Turn away means मुझे ऐसे जाने देंगी. He raised his voice. Amma, Amma, oh. So he started screaming, Amma, Amma, calling her out. Sad his wail might be, but it certainly wasn't feeble. So the narrator is saying that the voice may be sad because he wanted, he wanted that food and all. But that sound or that noise, the voice, it was not a feeble. Feeble nahi thi, jo unki wail thi. Wail means what? The cry for food and all. It was not feeble. Feeble means, of sound or the sound which is very low. Okay. He was having a proper sound, loud sound. Okay. It began in a deep, strong rumble. Rumble means sound. Somewhere in his withered belly. Withered means, withered in general is dry. But here it means the belly was empty. Okay. Jo unka belly tha, stomach tha, wo empty tha. Okay. So, and it came booming out of his mouth. So this, that voice was, although it was strong, but it was from his withered belly. That means unke jo stomach tha, empty stomach, uski sound thi, that I want something. Okay. With its few remaining teeth stained brown with beetle chewing. Okay. So unke jo teeth the, few were left and they were brown due to beetle chewing. Okay. Beetle chewing means due to the use of tobacco, unke teeth kaise ho gaye the? Brown. Okay. So, Ravi, tell him there's nothing left in the kitchen. Called Rukumani. Okay, so Rukumani said that there is nothing left in the kitchen. Just tell him that kuch bhi nahi hai humare paas. And he's not to come again. Tell him that. She sounded fed up. So, they were fed up. Fed up means irritated.
ओके सो शी सेड सो रुक्मणी सेड दैट टेल हिम दैट वी आर नॉट हैविंग एनीथिंग एंड टेल हिम टू गो अवे एंड नेवर कम बैक ओके एंड सी शी वॉज फेड अप इरिटेटेड रवि डिडंट हैव टू रिपीट इट ऑल टू द बेगर वॉट हिज मदर सेड हैड बीन ईजी फॉर देम ऑल टू हियर देयर अंडर द नीम ट्री सो एवरीथिंग वॉज ऑडिबल टू द बेगर ऑल्सो सो रवि डिडंट रिपीट एनीथिंग द बेगर सैट अप एंड साइड I'll go, he said wearily. Only let me have a rest here under this tree. So the beggar said that, okay, I'll go, but let me just rest here. So in a sad way, he said that, okay, I'll go, but please let me just rest under the
tree. And the sun is so hot and the tar has melted on the road.
My feet are already blistered. Blistered means those small boils that you have on your feet now when you walk on something hot. ओके जैसे आप छाले बोलते हो ओके ही स्ट्रेच आउट हिज फीट और हाउ यू नो टू शो लार्ज पिंक पीलिंग ब्लिस्टर्स ऑन द सोल्स ऑफ हिज बेयर फीट सो ही वॉज हैविंग नंबर ऑफ ब्लिस्टर्स ऑन हिज फीट एंड दैट मीन्स ही वॉज नॉट हैविंग स्लीपर्स विद हिम सो ही हैड टू मूव बेयर फीट यू नो मूव बेयर फीटेड ओके आई सपोज ही डजंट हैव द मनी टू बाय चप्पल्स मृदु विस्पर्ड टू मीना एंड रवि सो मीना यू नो मृदु विस्पर्ड टू मीना एंड रवि दैट आई थिंक ही इज नॉट हैविंग मनी टू बाय स्लीपर्स हैव यू गॉट एनी ओल्ड पेयर ऑफ स्लीपर्स इन द हाउस आई डोंट नो सेड रवि माइन आर टू स्मॉल यू नो और आई वुड हैव गिवन टू हिम एंड हिज फीट वर लार्जर देन मृदुज एंड मीनाज ऑल्सो सो नाउ यू नो The beggar was shaking out his upper cloth and tightening his dhoti. That means now the beggar was going to move onto that road on which tar was melting. He raised his eyes and looked fearfully at the road. Why fearfully? Because he was, you know, scared to move on that road barefooted because it was so hot. The road was so hot. And he had to move on it barefooted. That means without slippers. So he looked fearfully. Okay, now what happened?
He needs something on his feet. Meena said, her eyes failing. It's not fair, it's not fair. Said Ravi, I'm thinking about it, blubbering, whispering. It's not fair, it's not fair. Isn't going to help. So, you know, they were thinking to provide him with slippers. Okay, in 2 minutes, he'll be frying his feet on that road. What he needs is a pair of chappals. So now, they decided that they would provide him a gift of slippers or gift of chappals. So where do we get them? Come, let's search the house. He pushed Mridu and Meena into the house. Just as she stepped into the veranda, Mridu's eyes fell on the odd looking chappals she had noticed when she arrived. Do you remember the slippers? Right? Those slippers which she had seen when she entered the house. Right? The ones which were having the mark of big scrawny toes. So she saw those slippers. So she just asked, whose are those? Ravi turned and glanced at the shabby looking. Shabby means untidy looking. Sleepers, but they were sturdy, strong old sleepers. He beamed and nodded. These are just the right size, he said, picking them up. So he said that these are the right size. So let's just pick. So they just picked it up and just went towards the beggar to provide him with the sleepers. Now what happened? Here, said Ravi to the beggar, dropping the sleepers in front of the old man. Wear these and don't come back. The beggar stared at the sleepers, hurriedly flung his towel over his head, pushed his feet into them and left muttering a blessing to the children. So now they just gave the sleepers to the beggar and he just quickly wore those sleepers and just moved out, giving blessings to the children. Okay, so hurriedly flung means quickly he just wore those sleepers. Okay. Now, in a minute he had vanished. Vanished means disappeared. वो दिख नहीं रहे थे वो यू नो वो चले गए थे beggar. Disappeared or just vanished around the corner of the street. The music master came out of the house, took an unappreciative look at the three of them sitting quietly under the tree playing marbles. So now who came outside? The music master came outside, okay, and he saw that three of them were playing, you know, the marbles under the tree. Then he searched for his sleepers in the veranda where he had put them. So, whose sleepers were those? which were given to the beggar. They were of music master. So music master started searching for the sleepers in the veranda, but they were not there. Lali, he called after a few moments. She hurried up to him. Have you seen my chappals, my dear? I remember having kept them here. Ravi, Mridu, Meena silently watched. Lali and music teacher searched every corner of the veranda. So, you know, he just called Lali and asked that, have you seen my sleepers? And both of them were searching for the sleepers here and there. He screwed around, looking over railing, crouching near the flower pots to look between them. So, you know, he was looking at each and every corner, everywhere. Brand new they were. I went all the way to Mount Road to buy them, he went on saying. So he was just saying that they were brand new and I had gone to Mount Road to buy them, and they cost a whole month's fee, do you know? So he said that they were very expensive. Soon Lali went in to tell her mother. Rukmani appeared looking harassed with Pati following. Where could they be? It's really quite upsetting to think someone might have stolen them. So many vendors come to the door worried Pati. Rukmani caught sight of Ravi, Mridu and Meena sitting under the tree. So now Lali went inside and called her mother. Okay, and along with mother, Pati also came outside. Okay, so now they were like that, it is so upsetting if someone has stolen the sleepers. So it was so upsetting. ये बहुत दुख की बात है अगर किसी ने स्लीपर्स मेरे चुरा लिए हैं. Because number of vendors came to their house. So some of the vendor might have stolen the sleepers. So Rukmani, now what happened? Rukmani suddenly caught sight. Rukmani ने देखा that Ravi, Mridu and Meena were sitting quite under the tree. And she just got, you know, she just got that something is wrong. Kuch na kuch problem hai. Otherwise, they would have come to them. Okay. Have you children, she began. And then seeing they were curiously quiet, went on more slowly. Seen anyone lurking around the veranda? A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows. So, she just asked three of them. Have you children, have you seen anyone lurking around the veranda? Lurking means moving here and there. ओके क्या आपने किसी को देखा है वरांडा में द वन हु माइट हैव स्टोलन द स्लीपर्स बट दिस टाइम शी गॉट एंग्री अ वी शेप्ड लाइन बिटवीन द आईब्रोज वी शेप्ड लाइन विच शोज दैट शी वॉज अनॉयड एंड एंग्री अनदर स्ट्रेट टाइटर वन अपियर्ड इन प्लेस ऑफ हर यूजुअली ओके सो नाउ यूजुअली शी वॉज वेरी प्लेजेंटली फेस्ड शी वॉज सो यू नो स्माइलिंग एंड ऑल बट दिस टाइम शी वॉज एंग्री Thought Mridu with a so you know Mridu thought that she was angry and she was shivering, sort of shiver. Shiver means with fear. She wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with sores on his feet. She tried to tell herself. So she was just telling. Mridu was telling herself that she would, you know, not be angry if she knew. Agar unhe pata hota ki us beggar case, you know, she was not the beggar was not having sleepers. Isliye humne unki help ki hai. अगर ये बात उन्हें पता होती तो वो एंग्री नहीं होते टेकिंग अ डीप ब्रेथ शी क्राइड रुकमणि देयर वॉज अ बेगर हेयर पुअर थिंग ही हैड सच बॉल्स ऑन हिज फीट सो शी सेड दैट रुकमणि देयर वॉज अ बेगर कि यहाँ पे एक बेगर आए थे एंड ही हैड सो मेनी बॉल्स ऑन हिज फीट सो सेड रुकमणि ग्रिमली टर्निंग टू रवि सो रवि से उन्होंने पूछा दैट सो वॉट तो क्या हुआ You gave the music master's chappals to that old beggar who turns up here. So she said that did you give the sleepers to that beggar? Children these days, grown Pati. Amma, didn't you tell me about Karan who gave away everything he had, even his gold earrings. He was so kind and generous. Silly, snapped Rukmani. Karan didn't give away other people's things. He only gave away his own. So she said that Karan didn't give other people things, you know, और लोगों की चीजें नहीं दी उन्होंने अपनी चीजें दी थी ओके बट माई चप्पल्स wouldn't have fitted the beggar's feet. Ravi rushed brashly on. So he just, you know, argued or sort of replied, but मैं अपनी slippers कैसे देता My slippers would not have fitted the beggar's feet. And Amma, if they fit, would you really not have minded? Ravi, said Rukmani, very angry now. Go inside this minute. She hurried indoors and brought out Gopi Mama's hardly worn new chappals. So now he was just arguing. So angrily Amma said that just go inside and bring Gopu Mama's hardly worn. Hardly worn means they were almost new. Okay, sleepers. Okay. These should fit you, sir. Please put these on. I'm so sorry. My son has been very naughty. The music master's eye lit look too happy. Well, I suppose these will have up. So now, Rukmani was like, please wear these. They would fit your feet. And I'm so sorry for the naughtiness of my son. But the music master's eyes lit look too happy. So, unki eyes lit ho gayi. Lit means suddenly he got happy. And he said, yes, I suppose they will fit mine. That means they'll fit my feet. Okay. Well, I suppose these will have to do. These days, children have no respect for elders. What to do? A Hanuman incarnate, only Ram can save such a naughty fellow. So he said that these days, children are very naughty and they don't know how to respect their elders. Only Ram can save such naughty kids. Rukmani's eyes flashed. She didn't seem to like Ravi being called a monkey, even a holy monkey. She stood stiff and straight by the front door. It was clear she wanted him to leave quickly. So Rukmani was angry, or sort of angry, because he didn't like his son to be called a monkey, even a holy monkey. Right. So she just went towards the door asking. In a way, she was just asking the music master to leave the house. When he had clattered off in his new chappals, clattered means gone off noisily, that with the noise of the chappals. Okay, so she said, Mridu, come in and have some tiffin. Honestly, how do you children think of such things? So now the music master went away. Okay, so now Mridu just, it was asked that Mridu just come in and have some tiffin. So, she was asking, Rukmani was asking that how do you think of such things? Aap kaise soch lete ho ye sab cheeze? Thank God your Gopu Mama doesn't wear his chappals to work. And so she was just thanking that it's good if your Gopu Mama doesn't wear sleepers to the work. Otherwise, wo kaun si sleepers dete? Right, to the music master. As she walked towards the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, she suddenly began to laugh. Okay, she laughed at the incident. Jo bhi sab hua, she was just laughing that ye sab kitna funny tha. Okay, but he's always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chappals as soon as he comes home. So Rukmani said, but as soon as he comes, jaise aapke Gopu Mama ghar pe aate hain, as soon as he comes, he just through his hurry, he's in such a hurry that he just throw his shoes and socks, and he's always in a hurry to get into the sleepers. Jaldi se unhe kya chahiye hote hain? Jaldi se apne chappals chahiye hote hain. What is your mama going to say this evening when I tell him I gave his chappals to the music master? But aaj kya hoga? Aaj kya kahenge aapke mama? Because today I've given his sleepers to the music master. So what would be his reaction now? So this is how this funny incident took place. So students, this is why the title of the story is appropriate, is suitable, a gift of chappals. Okay, so this gift of chappals was given to whom? The beggar. Okay, so this is how your story comes to an end. I hope you all have enjoyed the story. Just go through the story, read it carefully. Okay, go through the word meaning. Still you have any query, you have just feel free to ask me. So students, see you in your next English class. Till then, just take care. Thank you.